How many of you flat sketch regularly and have trusted methods that you've been using and perfecting for years? Same. But here's the thing. Even though these methods work effectively, you and I both know that Adobe regularly updates their software and introduces new tools to make it even easier and more productive for us to do our jobs. But because we're often just getting things done, we miss some of those updates or neglect to update our skills. And often something or someone asks a question that prompts me to try something new. And that's what happened in a recent face-to-face class. My student asked about drawing a fashion flat with mirroring on. And I was kind of like, I don't know about that. But I went with it and found a new and pretty effective method of sketching that I'm going to share with you all today. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Mikkel Drew Pelham. I talk about digital fashion design software and communication on this channel. So if that's something you're interested in, make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell. Now, when I first started teaching Illustrator years ago, I got a lot of questions from people I was tutoring about how to sketch fashion flats with mirroring turned on. And for those of you unfamiliar with what this is, it just means that as you draw one side, the sketch is being mirrored on the opposite side. I learned a method to do this years ago, but it was just okay. So most of us just resigned ourselves to the fact that this wasn't something we could do in Illustrator. And we all just learned to draw half and then reflect it. Fast forward to now, and there's actually a great way to do this using one of Illustrator's newer functions. The first time I demoed this method was in this video, but I still demoed it where I'd drawn half of the sketch already, not showing mirroring as you draw. I also think there were some things about it that caused some other issues and added a lot of extra steps, but they've improved it since then. So here's how it works. Start drawing your flat sketch. And note that you do need to at least draw one or two lines before you can enter into the mirroring mode. So say we're drawing a basic T, I'm just going to start by drawing the top of the back neck. Then go to Object, Repeat, Mirror. This will automatically enter you into mirror repeat mode. And like being in isolation mode, you'll see a gray bar across the top of the page. Everything else is grayed out and only the lines you draw will be at full saturation. Continue drawing, and as you draw, your sketch lines will also show on the opposite side of the flat sketch. Now, I've gotten used to drawing half and not seeing a full sketch until I reflect, but I do recall when I first started flat sketching in Illustrator, really wanting a feature like this. It just makes things so much easier, and I suspect it'll make things easier for anyone else who is new to flat sketching. Once you've finished your symmetrical flat sketching, and I'm saying it that way because if you notice, there's a few drape lines I need to add to this, but those don't appear exactly the same on each side of the T. You'll exit out of mirror mode by clicking inside the gray bar. Now, if all you're doing is creating black and white flat sketches, say for tech packs, this is really all you need to do. However, for most of us, we eventually need to fill that fashion flat with color and pattern. And so these next steps are necessary. Whenever you create something in mirror mode, it essentially creates a grouped clipping mask that you'll need to expand and ungroup so that you can get to the individual objects and paths. And this is crucial to using the shape builder so we can create the shapes to later add color and pattern. So the next thing you need to do is expand the mirrored repeat. Select the T and go to Object, Expand. Leave Object and Fill checked and then hit OK. Next, release the clipping mask by going to Object, Clipping Mask, Release. Lastly, ungroup twice. And this needs to be done twice in order for you to be able to select each path individually. Before moving to creating shapes, you'll need to get rid of the box that Illustrator has created around the garment. Hover near the outside of the sketch, and the smart guide should help you find the box. You can also draw a selection box around the area to find it. Once you do, select it, there will be a left and right side, and delete it. Now select the solid lines in your sketch, switch to Shape Builder, and click in the gridded areas to form the shapes. You can even add your color as you're clicking. Rearrange the sketch so that any stitch or draping details appear on top of the color areas. Group the sketch and you're all done. I like this new method. And in fact, I think I'm going to start adding this into my regular teaching rotation. It's just as effective and just as quick as doing it the way I normally teach it. Will I start using it? Not sure yet. I think I'm so used to my own method that I'll probably just naturally gravitate to that. And since it takes about the same amount of time, I'm not increasing my productivity by switching to the new method. But I do think that if you're new to drawing fashion flats in Illustrator, you may want to try this method. It's enough to get used to flat sketches, but then also getting used to only seeing half the sketch, that can be a bit tricky. So seeing your lines mirrored to the opposite side as you draw can make learning to flat sketch a little bit easier. Thanks for watching today's video. If you need to learn how to use Illustrator for fashion design sketching, tap the link in the description to sign up for my online course. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share this video if you find it helpful. Have a fantastic week, and I'll see you next time.